Hi, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about how to attract a compatible life partner. Compatibility can come in two levels. There's the spiritual aspect of it, which is that's the real core of it. In fact, I think that's the only real compatibility that we should be looking for. Because if someone has those spiritual attributes, then they can translate it into the physical things that you will desire or want. So there's the spiritual side of it, and then there's the physical aspect. So I have noticed that most people, you know, have something like a checklist. Is it in their mind or is written down? Sometimes they've written down the checklist, and most of the ones I've seen or I've heard of are mainly physical attributes that they look for in people. So I'll just draw something like a table. I'll call it checklist. Checklist. Yep. So there's the spiritual, and then there's the physical. Now, what do people look for in most people that I know, you know, are looking for somewhere that has a car or somewhere that has a good paying job. They look at height. Are you tall or are you short? They look at skin color. Are you black? Are you white? Are you Asian? Some people, you know, these are the things that they look out for. They also look out for, what else, let's say, whether you're black or white, whether you're tall, whether you have a car, whether you have a job. These are the physical things, you know, that people look out for. How you look, your looks, and all those other physical things that we tend to look out for in a person. Now, all these things, they can be deceitful if you're not careful. These things do not define who the person is. They don't have much to do with your compatibility with somebody. They are important, you know. Then of course, whether you're rich or poor, these are the things we look out for. They're important, but they don't really touch at the core of somebody's soul, what the person is going to do with you, how somebody is going to behave with you. And the part that we tend to ignore, you know, is the part I think I want to talk about today that is more important than these ones. You can get these ones from these ones and you will be content. Now, I'll just use myself as an example. What I was looking for, you know, is someone that will bring peace to my life. Someone that will believe in me. Somebody that is self-aware. Somebody that will support you. Someone that will allow, give you freedom to be yourself. What else? Someone that will give you the freedom to be yourself. Someone that will be patient. Patient with you. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, yeah. So these are some of the spiritual attributes, you know, that you're looking for in someone. Someone that's that will give you that self-aware. Someone that's growth oriented too. Someone that understands what it means to grow. Someone that's growing, trying to improve themselves. And this is it. Maybe someone that is loyal to you too. Yeah. So, for you to attract this kind of person here on this side of the equation, you yourself will have to be all these things. You must find peace. You must have found peace within yourself, or you're in the process. You're in the process of finding that peace. You have decided, you have committed to having peace in your life. Then you can attract someone that has peace in their life. You have to believe in yourself. You have to be self-aware. If you're not self-aware, you cannot even know if somebody else is self-aware or not. It's not possible for you to know. You're only going to know if you yourself have all these qualities. You have to be growth-oriented. You have to be patient with yourself. You need to have given yourself freedom. Freedom here. What I mean by freedom is you must have cut yourself off most of the negative roadblocks or stumbling blocks that have been holding you back in the past. You must have done that job within yourself of being in a state of mind, where you're developing yourself personally. That's the freedom I'm talking about. You must have the courage to be free. You must have broken loose from your past, whatever was dragging you back before. That's the only time you can find somebody that's also loose from their own past. And together, you can fly as high as you want to fly. Your partner has to be your number one supporter. Number one supporter. Which, of course, you yourself should be your number one supporter first, before someone else comes to support you. That's an additional thing. Then you need to be self-aware. Self-aware should be number one, because if you're not self-aware, you're not even going to be able to recognize the right person when they come. You won't know when they come. You'll be looking out for these things, which are okay. There's nothing wrong with these things. Someone that has a job is good. They are good, but they're not the primary qualities that you look for in people, basically. They're not the primary quality. Now, it doesn't mean that somebody here does not have this. They might have it or they might not. It depends on where they are on their journey. Someone that's gone quite far and is advanced in their journey will probably have maybe not the height and all these other things, but like the other physical things, like these ones have to do with genetics. They're not things that anybody can control. So, but this one and this one and this, yeah, you can be spiritual. I have those things, But these ones are not, I don't know how you're going to decide this. That's your own decision to make. But this one is artificial. Should really be cancelled out of this. This is a little artificial too. And this is very artificial. Yeah. So these are the things that we're looking for in somebody. And now, why do I say, that you need to have this before you can attract somebody, someone that has these same qualities? Now, it boils down to the nature of reality. I don't want to go too far, too deep into the nature of reality. So I will just take you on a little, I'll take you on a little biological journey, so that we understand. This is not a checklist again, so that we understand where I'm rooting my argument from. Now, if you look at the DNA, the DNA is now, so I'm going biological now so that you understand that it also has a biological root. The DNA itself, it's like this, and it's a double helix. And both sides are complementary. This is what we're looking for, a complementary partner. I don't want to go too deep into the science, but they are joined together, by what they call base pairs, and those birthdays are matching. They are matching, and this is what determines everything that happens in our body. Most of the things that happen in our body. This is the real instrument. Now, when this DNA or whatever we call it, is replicating, there's a the process again, still has to do with complementarity. So you can't have one without the other. So when it's replicating, there are different enzymes that come to work on it. So what happens is, when the strand is separated, because it's a double-stranded molecule. So when it's separated, some enzymes, there are different enzymes that work on it. So they just come and replication means that it's doubling itself. This one now attracts his day's partner. Let me just put it like that, and this is how it's formed. Yeah, so for you to attract somebody, you have to be there. You have to be the original strand that is there. And when you have these qualities in you, the universe or whatever energy source that is bringing work, that does the work for us, is going to find somebody that matches you like this, And if it doesn't match, then they're not going to bind. They only bind to, what matches. And yeah, that's what I was talking about. From the level of from inside ourselves, So yeah, that's the message for today. We look out for the spiritual and also how it blends with the physical. So this is the spiritual, these are the spiritual attributes. And these are our external expectations. You can't have one without the other. One must always, because we're not living in a purely spiritual world, we also live in a physical world. This is physical. So we must deal with the physical. So this is the sweet spot here. Sweet spot. This is where, I like to operate from. I like to find a balance between the spiritual and the physical. So as I'm working on myself, I'm also working towards living in the physical world and making an impact in the physical world. And that's how I try to balance my two aspects here. So you're not really meant to be searching for, you're really meant to just be on your journey. And by developing yourself spiritually, by doing your personal development, the places that you go to will not be places that bring you harm. And those good places that you're going to, those beneficial places that you're going to, is where you're going to meet, that's where you may meet, in fact, you will meet whoever you're looking for, because they need to be on the same kind of path with you. They need to be, on a similar journey as you are. So it still boils down again, to the self. Everything starts from us. Everything starts from within. If you don't change the within, it's from what you have within that you can attract what is without. And there's no other way I can explain it, but it's very simple. Everybody has been saying it. People have been saying it for years. And it really works. I'm just here to confirm it, to tell you that it works. So thank you, and I'll see you in the next video.